I'm Don Sackett. I'm one of the founders and the CEO of SciAps, and we're at our factory here in just north of Boston in Woburn. And what we're doing is we're going to put up some demos of our latest and greatest X-ray analyzer and LIBS analyzer. The reason we're doing that is because of the current public health crisis, we have a lot of our customers that can't accept visitors or can't travel. We've had a lot of trade shows postponed or canceled. So a lot of people that want to see and look at a new analyzer don't have an opportunity to do so for the near future, we hope. So what we're doing is we're going to make some videos, some nice demo videos of the product, a couple of different applications. And if you are interested, you can contact us and we'll set up an online demo for you and any of your colleagues anywhere in the world. And if you want to buy a unit, we can ship it to you and we can set up remote training via the web. So we can get you demoed, we can get you trained and really support you well with all of our really good product specialists here. And then once this crisis subsides and we can all travel again and go out and see people, we will be happy to show up and give you some in-person training or in-person tune-up training, whatever you think you might need. So with that, let me introduce this great new X550 XRF analyzer. This thing has just taken the market by storm. It's just a beautifully designed analyzer. And if you start with this, first of all, it's only 2.75 pounds, so it's the lightest XRF ever made. Despite that really light weight, it's got a mostly metal frame. The snout's metal. It goes to a metal heat sinking with all these fins, again, all metal. Not only does that provide strength and structural support, but it also gives great heat dissipation. So you can use this thing all day long in just virtually any climate. So this is the analyzer. Some other nice features. This is the front of the nose, the window. If you break the proline window, you pop off this plate and replace it. If you're doing in-service PMI at very high temperatures, there's a capton, a thin capton window that comes with it. The analyzer has two cameras. It has an internal camera for looking at samples and welds. It has a macro camera, more like a cell phone camera, which you can take pictures of surrounding things, of the materials. It'll even read a barcode. So that's the front. As you see, I'm wearing my wrist strap. We warranty the unit to drops, but we ask that you do wear the wrist strap when using it. It is not an inexpensive analyzer. On the underneath side, we have the ports. Right now, I'm connected to the USB port for the camera. There's also another data port for field firmware and software upgrades, and then there's the AC power if you want to run the unit by AC power and also charge the battery. There's the wrist strap. Speaking of the battery is back here. You can pop it out of the unit anytime. You can pop it back in. It is keyed. See if this channel is keyed here. It's keyed there, so you can't put it in backwards. So you pop that thing right in. It's also hot swap battery, so as long as you put the battery back within a minute, you don't lose power. You don't have to reboot anything. And let's see, that's it. So you see the back of the unit with the UI. It's all Android system. You fire it up, you tap analyze, you choose whatever you're gonna test, alloy, and off you go, you're ready to test. You swipe up, hit that to get back to your home screen, just like your Android phone. In terms of the battery and the battery charger, take my wrist strap off for a minute. Here's the charger base right here. When it's plugged in, you have a red light. Battery goes in like that, and it switches to blinking green when it's charging, and solid green when it's fully charged. Again, the battery's keyed here, it's keyed here, so you can't jam the battery in the wrong way. So charger, the unit, besides having USB, it's got Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and GPS, so you can get data off wirelessly as well. And then the unit, when it's on, it's got the bright green. That's your power switch right there. You press that, it boots up in about 10 or 15 seconds. You've got your bright green indicator. When you're testing a sample, as you'll see, go to analyze, go to alloy. You're testing a sample. See, it's blinking red during the testing, which is required. When it's not emitting X-rays, but the tube still has power, it's solid red. And it stays solid red until the tube is powered off.